Hey Viking fans, this is Keith Millard, and you are listening to the One Bar and Lupicus Show. Go Vikes!
All right, welcome back to the One Bar and Lupicus Show. I'm One Bar with Lupicus and Vikings, just not wasting any time loading up that secondary. Mackenzie Alexander is back, and I am elated.
I love it. I mean, I love the move. I love Mackenzie Alexander. Didn't want to see him go a year ago, but I'm also very, very confused. You just signed Patrick Peterson. You got Cam Dantzler. You got Jeff Gladney. Now you got Mac Alexander. So the first thing this screams to me is that Mike Hughes' career might be over.
Yeah, I mean, Mackenzie Alexander, one of the best slot corners, I'm not going to say in the NFL, but he's a damn good slot corner. And he can get after it in the secondary. He can get after it pass rushing. Was very sad to see him go. I was surprised last year it took him so long to actually get signed by the Bengals. Didn't get that huge contract. But very excited to have Mackenzie Alexander back in the mix. But I agree, Mike Hughes, something is definitely amiss there. But one thing is clear, our cornerback position is not an issue anymore.
Yeah, you can rule out Patrick Surtain. You can rule out J.C. Horn. There's no way in hell the Vikings are taking a cornerback early in this draft. You still got Harrison Hand. You got Chris Boyd. I mean, really, you're kind of six deep right now. Does this mean Harrison Hand, is he going to transfer into a transition to a safety? I don't know, but like you mentioned, Mackenzie Alexander as a blitzer he's damn near elite. Four sacks a couple years ago. And the fact he came back, to me, speaks volumes about the head coach. You already heard it from Patrick Peterson, wanted to play with Zim. I thought maybe there was something going on there when Alexander didn't resign, especially for the one-year deal he got from the Bengals. But the fact he wants to come back, be part of this, be back in Minnesota, I think it speaks volumes about the guy in charge.
Yeah, and he's still only 27 years old. He'll be 27 years old when the season starts. Still no real numbers as far as what it is. I'm going to guess that it's a probably pretty team-friendly deal. I'm going to say it's probably another one-year deal. I could be way off. But Mackenzie Alexander's still in that area where he could do a one-year prove-it, maybe get some money elsewhere next year. But, this gives us a lot of options. Like you said, Harrison Hand, as he bumped back to safety? We still know safety is a big position, but I love Mackenzie Alexander so damn much.
Yeah, I didn't think this was going to happen after the Patrick Peterson signing. So the Vikings right now are pretty well set at cornerback. That was a need. I mean, I would have called it a secondary need even going into this free agency. I know you add Patrick Peterson, Mackenzie Alexander. It's now a strength, and I would say probably one of the stronger overall positions on the entire team.
Yeah, and you hate to say, this is a great move. Like Patrick Peterson, when he was signing, it's like, hey, worst case scenario, even if he doesn't have a Patrick Peterson type season, he's going to be able to mentor these youngsters. And I see it. I see Mackenzie Alexander being another guy who can mentor some of these guys, some of these young guys, and bring them to their potential. So this is a win-win-win. Like I said, I'd be shocked if this is just really hampering them when it comes to the salary cap. I think it's going to be very team friendly. I think that it is very clear the Vikings are hard up and hard down as far as improving this defense. And they made that very clear this free agency, and they've done it.
You look at it, we're just getting Daniel Hunter back, adding Delvin Tomlinson, improving the cornerback group. I mean, exponentially. I can't remember. I don't know if I say that word right.
I don't care. You said both words perfectly in my mind.
And the only thing that would maybe put up a red flag on me for this move would be, does it slow the development of Jeff Gladney? Does he get bumped back? Do Peterson, Alexander jump him on the depth chart and he sees all of a sudden, cornerback number four? I think Cam Dantzler is already ahead of him. So that's why I'm not bringing Cam Dantzler into this mix, but that's my only, and I just thought of this as you were talking. Is it going to bump Jeff Gladney down?
I see it as win-win. I don't see it bumping him down. I see it just making sure he's ready to go out there when he is ready. And Gladney, up and downs last year, just like Cam Dantzler. I think Mackenzie Alexander gives him the cushion where if he's not ready to go out there, so be it. He's still going to play a lot, but Mackenzie Alexander is ready. And this just gives a little bit of cushion, a cushion that they didn't have last year where they were just forced out there. This year, it's just, hey, we got all the guys. Go out there when you're ready. I'm hard as a rock.
Well, and you could say, like, hey, is Patrick Peterson going to play safety now? But he already flat out said in his interview, he's not playing safety. He's playing cornerback. That's what he's here for. So you can rule that out. So now we have four solid corners. two young guys with experience. I love this cornerback group right now very much.
And looking at the draft wise, you know, maybe this puts them in a position to actually reach for a Morig at pick 14, because putting him in the mix would make this secondary complete. I mean, it would be a little bit of a stretch, not a huge stretch, but they could really, this defense is going to be a 360.
Yeah. I mean, they've already, it's taken leaps and bounds here, improvement wise in free agency. And this is, this makes it even better. So I think we're both very ecstatic about this move. We both wanted Mackenzie Alexander back, never want to see him go. It's always great when you bring someone back, bring one of your own back. And I think literally this is, I mean, one of our favorite moves of free agency. And I don't think it's a stretch to say that at one bit.
Yeah. And after Peterson was done, we figured this was over, not a chance. He's here. It's fantastic. Let us know in the comments. What do you think of the Mackenzie Alexander move? Hashtag SOS. Almost 2,500 subs. Make sure to sub. Let's do this.
Remember this. Breathing the air in Beijing has the same health risks as smoking 21 cigarettes a day. Do not breathe if you're in Beijing.